If you're after an affordable family tablet, well, the Amazon Fire devices are usually a pretty good bet, though the Fire Max 11 is the biggest and also most expensive of the bunch. It'll cost you just over $200 in the States, although the price has been bumped up to 250 quid here in Blighty. But this mighty slab does boast a massive pin-sharp screen, you've got stellar battery life and support for some pretty nifty accessories. So let's whip it out of the box, gonna test it out and take you on a full tour. And for more on the latest and greatest tech, please do poke subscribe and ding that notifications bell. Cheers! So first up, what do you get stashed in this big old box? Besides the Fire Max 11, of course. Well, you've got yourself a 9-watt power adapter, USB power cable, a porky pin device, and a quick start guide, and that's your whack. If you fancy yourself a keyboard case or a stylus pen, those will cost you a bit extra. So the Amazon Fire Max 11 is a massive 11-inch tablet, as the name kind of heavily suggests. Thankfully, the bezels surrounding that display are reasonably skinny, so it isn't unnecessarily large. The only problem with these weenie bezels is that it's very easy for your thumbs to accidentally stray onto the very edge of the screen, at which point the responsiveness gets completely balked up. And this tab weighs a badger's ball under half a kilo, so it is quite light for something this size. And unless you happen to have absolutely massive hands, clutching it around the back like so ain't really particularly comfortable because it's just so big. I can already feel my fingers being pulled out of joint. And don't worry too much if you're going to pass off the Amazon Fire Max 11 to your weans, because apparently that front end has been protected with strengthened aluminous silicate glass. Aluminous silicate. Basically, you can take a proper pounding. Meanwhile, flip it over and you've got yourself a solidly constructed aluminium arse. This is made from 55% recycled materials. And this right here is the one available color, gray. Strap me down because I'm about to absolutely lose it over that sexy design. The Fire Max 11's back end does have a pleasing soft touch finish to it, but as you can see there, ever so swiftly gathers up greasy fingerprints and other scuffy marks. So not a good one if you're super precious about all of your things looking nice and neat and pristine at all times. So let's just do a quick tour of all of the ports, buttons, etc. Most of the action is happening over here on the right edge. You've got your power button, your volume rocker, your Type-C USB port, and also your memory card slot. You can yank this out with a little help from that porky pin device that Amazon stuffed in there, and then shove in a microSD memory card to expand the storage. And the rest of the Fire Max 11, pretty straightforward. Down below, you've just got the connector pins for attaching the keyboard dock, pair of stereo speakers up top. Now, the fact you've got that fingerprint sensor built into that power button means you don't need to mess around with pins or passwords every time you want to boot up the Fire Max 11. Just literally tap your finger against that power button and it'll pop to life. And the Fire Max 11 doesn't run Google Android or anything like that. It runs Amazon's own FireOS. Quite a different beast, unsurprisingly geared around Amazon's own products and services. And it is worth pointing out that the Fire Max 11 will serve you ads unless you pay Amazon an extra tenner when you purchase the tablet in order to take those ads away. A little bit cheeky when you're spending this amount of money on a device. I've got the version without ads, so I can't tell you how intrusive these things are, whether it's worth the extra £10, but I'd say it probably would be, because I freaking hate ads. Even though that's kind of how I make money and therefore don't have to get a real job, but hey-ho. If you've never used a Fire tablet before, well, basically all of your apps are served up on the main screen. There's no kind of apps tray or anything like what you get on Android. And also up top here, you've got a shortcuts bar which allows you to jump straight back into whatever you were doing. And also basically acts as a, hey, you might be interested in this stuff that we've got on the Amazon services. You've also basically got an expanded version of this bar if you swipe right. Lots of popular apps and games and films and stuff you can get if you chuck more money at Amazon. And then if you were to swipe left, this is all the stuff you already own, your library. So Kindle books, apps, games, Audible, the whole lot is represented here. And it's fully customizable as well, as you can swap around the order they appear in or hide some stuff you're not really bothered about. For instance, I sadly no longer have Prime Video, so I'm gonna get rid of that row. And poof, it disappears. You've also got a handy search bar up top which you can use to search the internet as well as the device itself. And an Android-style notifications tab that you can pull down. This will show you any emails or anything that have popped in since you last checked. You've also got fast access to a bunch of toggles, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, etc. So as you can see, heavily centered around Amazon's own services. So if you don't really use the likes of Prime Video, the Kindle Store, Audible, etc., you're probably going to get quite annoyed by this UI. And also bear in mind, there is no Google Play Store access here. You're using Amazon's own App Store instead. And thankfully, this is very well stocked these days because it's been going for absolutely years and years. So for instance, you've got all of the major media streaming apps on here, like iPlayer, Sky, 4OD, Disney Plus, etc. And plenty of stuff to keep the old kiddywinks entertained as well. But yeah, you won't find any of Google's own apps on here, so no Gmail, no Google Chrome, no YouTube, boohoo. Instead, you'll have to use alternative options like video for YouTube, which is fine. Basically works in much the same way, just doesn't look quite as pretty. And of course, if you want to stay productive, well, you can always grab yourself the Fire Max 11 keyboard case, which will cost you an extra 90 quid on top of the tablet price, eep. As you can see, this actually comes in two separate parts. This bit slaps onto the back end of the Fire Max 11 and gives it a nice felty finish. And this can actually be used to prop the tablet up, like so. And then you've got the keyboard dock portion of it, which just snaps onto the bottom end of the tablet. And of course, as always with tech, there's immediately an update that needs doing. And it's a pretty typical keyboard dock, the kind you find on all kinds of different tablets. Because this is an 11-inch tab, it's actually a pretty decent size. Those chiclet keys are nicely spread and spaced. You've got quite limited travel when you do bash those keys because it is quite a skinny dock, but it's not terrible. I find I could touch type on this thing with ease. And I really wouldn't bother with the hilariously weenie touchpad because you've got a touch screen anyway. Just bear in mind that this keyboard isn't backlit, so if you want to be doing some tappy-tapping in the dock, then you're shit out of luck. And Amazon also gives you the option of purchasing a stylus pen for the Fire Max 11. As you can see, this comes with the stylus itself, a battery, doesn't have a built-in battery, you've got to slot that one in. You've also got a spare nib and a pincer tool to remove the tip and replace it with another. And if you are planning on giving this tablet to your kids just to get them to shut the hell up, you can set up a kid's profile. This just gives them limited access to the apps that you want them to use. So thankfully, for instance, they can't just go on Amazon and spend £2,000 on toys. Now, as this is an Amazon tablet, it unsurprisingly comes with full built-in support for the voice assistant, who will not be named because otherwise I'll set her off in everybody's homes. You can activate her and deactivate her nice and easy at any point just by dragging down at the notifications toolbar. As you can see, you've got the hands-free option right there. Turn it off if you want a bit of privacy, turn it on if you want to basically turn the Fire Max 11 into a smart display. And because it's an 11-inch tablet, it actually works really well as a smart display. Just slap it in your kitchen, bedroom, wherever, prop it up with that case, and then you can just shout at it to turn on your lights, play some music, call your Aunt Dorothy while you're scrubbing your spuds, whatever your heart desires. It's a much cheaper alternative to Google's Pixel tablet, which has a similar vibe and is hitting the UK soon for £599. Now, Amazon is offering the Fire Max 11 in a choice of two flavors, 64 gigs or 128 gigs, depending on how much media and how many apps and everything you're going to be downloading. Of course, you do have the option of expanding that storage using a micro SD memory card, and Amazon will, of course, very kindly point you in the right direction of memory cards on the Amazon website. And one of the highlights of the Amazon Fire Max 11 tablet is undoubtedly that 11-inch IPS panel. The visuals on this almighty screen are super crisp thanks to the 2000 by 1200 pixel resolution. It's very well suited to kicking back with a nice bit of cinematic fare. And while it's not OLED tech, thankfully the contrast is reasonably good. Blacks don't just look kind of murky grey. Colours are pretty poppy as well, so certainly it'll suit the whole family for just watching some shows, some movies, whatever. Those viewing angles are decent if a couple of heads want to cram together to watch something. But on the maximum brightness, you will be struggling to see what's going on outdoors if it is a sunny day. Be fine for using in cars and the like, but you'll want to seek out some shade if you're properly in the sun. You've also got yourself a pair of stereo speakers, which can get pretty bloody loud when you boost them right up, certainly to the point where they'll annoy the living heck out of you if your kid's blasting Peppa Pig on top volume. The clarity stays pretty good even on that top volume, so certainly if you want something to watch a bit of Netflix, YouTube, whatever, while you're in a kitchen noisily making dinner, then this will do the job. Now sadly, there's no headphone jack here on the Amazon Fire Max 11, which seems like a bit of a strange omission, but you do have Bluetooth 5.3 streaming support, so you can just slap a pair of wireless headphones if you're trying to get a bit of privacy, bit of peace. Now, if you like to use your tablet to do a bit of Skype and zoom in with the family, whatever, you've got an 8 megapixel front-facing camera right here. That was just above the screen when the tablet is in landscape mode. as well as a pair of mics slapped either side of that USB-C port. This camera can capture your mug in full HD resolution, so nice and crisp, and it can deal with tricky contrast as well if you happen to be sat in front of a window or whatever. Those mics do a pretty good job of picking up your voice cleanly and clearly as well, although if the environment is quite noisy, you do tend to get drowned out a little bit. And Amazon has also slapped on an 8 megapixel rear camera, which is kind of a shame because people who use tablets to shoot photos and videos are just plain wrong. And the Fire Max 11 is powered by a MediaTek chipset, the MTK8188J to be precise. And so far my time with the tab, I've got to say I'm pretty happy with that performance. Everything feels pretty smooth here on this tab, the occasional little wee judder here and there, but nothing major. And you can play simple games here on the Fire Max 11, but this tablet is definitely best suited to simple like point and click style adventure games and puzzle games. As for the battery life on this Amazon tablet, well, it's nothing short of excellent. You'll easily get a full long day of use out of a single charge. We're talking easily 10 plus hours of mixed use, over a dozen hours if you're just streaming video. It's certainly ideal for keeping your kids quiet on those long ass road trips. However, it does also take over 4 hours to fully recharge when it is drained, so you're gonna wanna plug it in overnight, really. So that right there, in a lovely wee nutshell, is Amazon's fresh new Fire Max 11 tablet. And certainly if you want a tablet with a big screen for kicking back with some movies or shows or whatever, and you want something with the flexibility of that keyboard dock so you can smash out some emails or essays on the go, well, all good. Of course, it ain't cheap compared with some of the other Amazon Fire tablets out there, and if you're not fully stuck into that Amazon ecosystem, well, you're probably not going to get the most out of this tab. Anyhow, that's what I think. It'd be great to hear your own thoughts down in the comments below. Please do poke, subscribe, and ding that notifications bell for more on the latest and greatest tech. And have yourselves a ruddy, wonderful rest of the week. Cheers, everyone. Love you.